Hello everyone, welcome to a new video. This time we are building the amphibian tank T-38. This kit I buy in Romania, there are a link in description. This kit is like the other one from Romania, a special plastic. But this amphibian tank T-38 is actually a pretty good kit and I like it very much. This video is, like you see, very long, so I hope you will enjoy it. I am showing in this video how I am building the kit and how that will go, and you will see me use a lot of different colors of wash and how I blend the colors together with water. It is a wash from Valeo and I used the wash before I put on some varnish. And Valeo washes, if you use it with the water, it is actually working pretty good. But of course, first is the build of the vehicle. And this kit is going to get us pretty good. There are some small mistake on the kit, but that doesn't matter. It is going together very well and it is looking pretty good. The wire that was in the kit I am gluing together, you see here, and it doesn't matter when it is glued together, you cannot see it has been broke off. Thank you. this kit come with two different ways you can put on a machine gun or a cannon. Here I am showing how you can choose which one you want to use. I use the machine gun because it is how it is looking inside the game Heroes&General World War II. Here I am showing that there are some missing plastic around the edge where the turret should be, but I glued a turret on, so it is not a problem. Here I am gluing all the track together, and there is a missing part there, but I put this part up under the on top of the track so you will not see it because I put it behind. And here I am finished with the vehicle. Here are just a few pictures, and then it's time for priming. I am using some white primer because I have a lot of white primer. And when you use white primer, the color you put on after that is a little bit lighter. Here you see how the paint is separating in colors, so it needs to be shaken a lot. This paint is also a primer. I use this primer because I was thinking this color is a very good green color for this vehicle. For me, it's not important if it is a primer or not. And on all my airbrush, I use air flow improver, and that is working very good. I just mix it a little bit. Sometimes I use a thinner. It is about what paint I use, but for this one I don't need a thinner. Thank you. when I was finished with the green primer, I decided that this was not the correct color, so I find myself a Russian green color I have in my stash, and that color is looking better, and this is not a primer. And the day after the vehicle was completely dry, I take the light gray, green primer and mix it with some white, and then I paint some dry brushing and on all the knots on the vehicle, and I do some small scratch with the lighter green. And then I use some wash and I put water before I put the wash on the vehicle. Here it is the engine outtake. I use black wash. Here I am doing the same process. First I put water on the vehicle and then I put some wash. And the wash is of course looking weird and maybe too much when it is wet, but when it's, the wash dry up, it is looking pretty good. And then I just blend the color, edge of the color, so it looks more fine, and I use water for this too. Yeah, I'm painting some details, and after that I painted with wash in the edge of the vehicle on the turret. Here with the track and all that, I soak it in water and then I use wash again. And I will, this time I try to paint the wheels with wash to see how that will go. I didn't paint the edge of the wheels with black color or something else. I just used the wash just to see how that will go, and I think it is okay. After the wash, I put the wash on, I use a dry brush to blend a little bit and for making some streaking effect. Thank you. I was checking the picture from inside the game, and I could see that around the turret there was a little bit blue something color. So I decided to try that, and in start, when I put the wash on, it was looking very, very much too much. But when I used the rust effect, it actually came out pretty good. Yeah, as you see, I use a lot of cleaning. So I remove a lot of the blue color. But it is giving a great depth to all the colors. For the track, I use some brown color, and then I use some rusty wash after that, and that is looking pretty good. I know there is a lot of color talk in this video, but it is because I am using many different paint and washes for this vehicle, and it is actually pretty funny to try out how the wash and paint is working when you blend it together, and the end result when it is dry is a lot different from when it is wet. While some of the wash is drying, I painted some of the detail, and then I go back to wash and I put some more rust on the vehicle and details and all that, and you can see that here, for example. Yes, and then it's time for a decal. This vehicle will only get one decal, and that will be on the turret. There are many decals for the vehicle, but as you know, I'm trying to make it look like it is in the game Heroes&General WW2, so they only have this decal on. I didn't use varnish before the decals. I want to try to put the decal on and see how that will go. and I am thinking that this is working pretty good. I was looking at the pictures from the in-game again, and I could see after the vehicle was dry up, I need some more color in front of the vehicle and behind around the exhausting. So one more time I use wash and blend again. And as you can see here, it is working pretty good. Lots of different colors is blending together. And here I am stippling some rust on the edge of the vehicle. It is looking very nice. I'm very happy with the result. And here at the end of the video, as usual, there are a few pictures from the finished vehicle. That's all for now. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye bye.